Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we're going to do this very simple slider style lower third. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new composite shot, and it will only be 3 seconds long because it doesn't really have to be that long. So what I'm going to start by doing is creating a new text layer. I think I will go ahead and make it 1850 wide so that it's just off the left edge. And then I can just type in, whatever is going to be in the text layer, and then go ahead and, make it look the way that I want it to look. From here, I'm just going to go ahead and move it into the position where I want it to be as far as where the lower third will occur. I'm going to go ahead and create a new plane layer, and I'm going to leave it black, clicking OK, but I am going to use the fill color effect and just drag that onto the plane, opening it up. I will change the blend amount to 100%. That way it's completely white. And from here, I can just grab a corner and then adjust it so that it's about where I want it to be as far as being the line that's going to expose the lower third text. And then from here, if I just highlight that, I can bring it down and I can bring it over so that it is sitting essentially where it will end up after it has slid over. From here, I want to add another plane, and this plane will actually be the mat. So using my F2 key, I am going to rename it mat. And then I want to slide it over so that it is in line with the line here. Okay. And then both of those two will move at the same time. So I'm going to create a new point layer, and I will rename that point control. And then I want to take the plane that is the line and parent it to the control point, as well as the mat, parenting it to the control point. That way, if I move the control point, I'm going to move my mat plane as well as my line. Okay. So if I move in, say, about 10 frames, and I open up the control point and I keyframe the position of that, maybe make it smooth. Back up to here, I can just go ahead and slide it over so that it's off the screen like this, maybe negative 530 or so. Then I come to 10 frames before the end. I can go ahead and add another keyframe here, making it smooth. And when I go to the very end, I can just copy that same keyframe here like that. That way, that will slide in and then it will slide out, right? Now all I have to do is just use the plane as the mat to expose or cover the lower third text. So what I will do is search for the set mat effect. I will drag that actually onto the text itself. And if I open up the properties for that, I will say source layer mat, and then I will change the blend mode to subtract and invert it. So now we should have the situation where that covers and uncovers. But you say, wait a minute, the mat is still there. Well, that's because I have it turned on. If I turn it off, then it is completely transparent and can be laid over the top of any video that you want. Now, if you wanted to change the color of the plane, it's very easy to do that. If you want to change the color of the text, it's very easy to do that. If you want to change the actual text, how long it is, you can always readjust everything. But it's all set up now. You save this as a composite shot, use it as your template, and you'll be good to go. So if you have any questions about how to do this very simple lower third, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.